हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक। दिस इज़ द फिफ्थ लेक्चर ऑन बेवल गियर्स। इन दिस लेक्चर वी सॉ न्यूमेरिकल्स। लेट वी स्टार्ट। दिस इज़ द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट। एवरीवन केयरफुली रीड दिस प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट एंड ट्राई टू कलेक्ट गिवन डेटा। A pair of bevel gears with 20 degree pressure angle consist of a 20 teeth pinion meshing with a 30 teeth gear. The module is 4 millimeter while the face width is 20 millimeter. The material for the pinion and gear is steel 50C4, SUT 660 Newton per millimeter square. The gears are made machined to meet the specification of grade 8 and the surface hardness is 400 BHM. The pinion rotates at 500 RPM and receive power from the electric motor. The starting torque of the motor is 150% of the rated torque. Assuming a minimum factor of safety as 2, determine the rated power that the gear can transmit. Given terms, the Lewis form factor for various number of teeth are as in table below. Number of teeth, that is 21, 22, 23, 24 and 25, and capital Y is Lewis form factor for that respected teeth, 0.326, 0.330, 0.333, 0.333, 0.337, 0.34. The tooth error for grade 8 is E is equal to 16 plus 1.25 into inside the bracket module plus 0.25 under root D in microns. Okay, after reading the problem statement, first of all we collect the given data. Pressure angle alpha is equal to 20 degree. Number of teeth on a pinion Z sub XP is equal to 20. Number of teeth on a gear Z suffix G is equal to 30. Module M is equal to 4 millimeter. Face width B is equal to 20 millimeter. Ultimate tensile strength SUT is equal to 660 Newton per millimeter square. Hardness BHN is equal to 400. Speed of pinion N suffix P is equal to 500 RPM. Starting torque is equal to 150% of rated torque. Starting torque divided by rated torque, that is 150%, that is called as a service factor. The ratio of starting torque to the rated torque is called as a service factor, and that service factor is given 150%, means service factor C suffix S is equal to 1.5. Factor of safety F suffix S is equal to 2. Machining grade, that is 8. Now here we determine the rated power that the gear can transmit. Now for finding the rated power, we need to decide the criteria. Means here we find out the beam strength, wear strength, and the lower value is considered as a failure criteria, and that using this criteria we find out the rated power. Okay, now let we start. When we solve a problem on a spur, helical and bevel gear, the first step that is taken when we solve the problem, deciding the weaker. Okay, this is the first step, deciding the weaker between pinion and gear, and everyone knowing the deciding the weaker criteria. If the material are same for pinion and gear, pinion should be weaker, and if the material for pinion and gear are different, in that case we take a product of bending stress and Lewis form factor for pinion and gear, and after calculating the lower value is considered as a weaker. Okay, now in this case, both pinion and gear is made up of a steel 50C4. The material for pinion and gear is the same, therefore pinion should be weaker. After deciding the weaker, in step first, we do the raw calculation which is needed in next step. Okay, now we find out the pitch angle gamma for the pinion. We know the relation tan gamma is equal to Zp divided by Zg. Zp is equal to 20, Zg is equal to 30, 20 divided by 30, and we get take a tan inverse of this ratio, and we get a gamma pitch angle for pinion. Gamma is equal to 33.69 degree. Virtual number of teeth on pinion. We know the relation for virtual number of teeth on a bevel gear. Z dash is equal to Z divided by cos gamma. That relation is applied to the pinion. Z dash suffix p, virtual number of teeth on a pinion, Z dash suffix p is equal to Z suffix p divided by cos gamma. Now substitute the value. Zp is equal to 20 divided by cos gamma 33.69. Simplify that and we get a virtual number of teeth 24.0369. Okay, now here we need to find the Lewis form factor for virtual number of teeth. For finding the Lewis form factor for virtual number of teeth, refer a given table. Okay, now this calculated virtual number of teeth Z dash suffix p 24.0369 consider as a x. Remember this. Now refer a table. This is the given table. Here 24.0369, that value lies between 24 and 25. That's why 24 is considered as x1 and 25 is considered as x2, number of teeth. And the Lewis form factor for that respected tooth consider as a y1 and y2. y1 is equal to 0.337 and y2 is equal to 0.34. Now here we do the interpolation to get the Lewis form factor for virtual number of teeth 24.0369. y is equal to y1 plus y2 minus y1 into x minus x1 divided by x2 minus x1. Now substitute the value y1 0.337 plus y2 minus y1. y2 0.34 minus 0.337 into x minus x1. x 24.0369 minus 24 is the value of x1 whole divided by x2 minus x1. x2 is 25 minus x1 24. Simplify that and we get a value of virtual number of teeth. Sorry, we get a value of Lewis form factor for virtual number of teeth. y is equal to 0.33711. Bending stress sigma b, we know that how to find out the bending stress. Sigma b is equal to SUT by 3. We know the value of SUT, 660 divided by 3, and we get a bending stress 220 newton per millimeter square. After that, pitch circle diameter of pinion and gear. Pitch circle diameter of bevel pinion, capital D suffix p is equal to m into z suffix p. M is equal m 4 into zp 20. We get a pitch circle diameter for bevel pinion 80 millimeter. Similarly, pitch circle diameter of bevel gear D sub capital D suffix G is equal to M into Z suffix G 4 into 30, and we get the pitch circle diameter of bevel gear capital D suffix G is equal to 120 millimeter. After that, cone distance AO. Everyone knowing the relation for cone distance AO, that relation is already discussed in virtual number of teeth. AO is equal to under root dp by 2 bracket square plus dg by 2 bracket square, and we know the value of dp and dg. Substitute this value in this relation and we get a cone distance AO. Now under root 80 by 2 bracket square plus 120 by 2 bracket square. Simplify that and take a square root and we get the value of cone distance AO is equal to 72.1110 millimeter. This is the cone distance. This is the step number first. Okay, after deciding the weaker, here we do the all raw calculations which is needed in a next steps. Okay, now here we find out the power. For finding the power, decide the criteria, either bending stress and wear stress. That's why we need to find out the bending strength and wear strength. Now the next step is a Step number second, beam strength, SB. We know the relation for bending strength in case of a bevel gear. SB is equal to MB sigma B into Y into inside the bracket 1 minus B divided by AO. We know all the values, substitute these all the values in that relation and we get the beam strength. Module M 4 into base width 20 into 220 into 0.33711 into inside the bracket 1 minus 20 divided by 72.1110. Simplify that and we get a value of a bending strength. SB is equal to 4287.5769 Newton. Step number third, wear strength. We know the relation for wear strength in case of a bevel gear. SW is equal to 0.75 BQ capital D suffix P into K divided by cos gamma. Okay, now here in that relation only two terms are unknown, Q and K. Q is the ratio factor and K is the material constant. Now the ratio factor Q in case of a bevel gear, it is obtained by using the relation Q is equal to 2zg divided by 2zg plus zp, Q in case of a bevel gear, the ratio factor Q is obtained by using the relation Q is equal to 2zg divided by zg plus zp into tan gamma. Now we know all the values, substitute these all the values in that relation and we get a ratio factor Q. 2 into 30 divided by 30 plus 20 into tan 33.69 degree. Simplify that and we get a value of a ratio factor Q. Q is equal to 1.3846. Material constant K, we know the relation for material constant when both the gears are made up of steel with a pressure angle 20 degree. K is equal to 0.16 into inside the bracket BHN divided by 100 bracket square. 0.16 inside the bracket 400 divided by 100 bracket square. Simplify that, we get a value 2.56 Newton per millimeter square. Okay, after getting Q and K, substitute this value in relation of wear strength. SW is equal to 0.75 into 20 into Q 1.3846 into D suffix P 80 into K 2.56 whole divided by cos 33.69 degree. Simplify that. After simplification, we get a value of wear strength 5112.0561 Newton. Okay, now here we observe beam and wear strength. Beam strength is less than wear strength, therefore bending failure is the design criteria. Means here we find out the rated power based on a beam strength. Okay, now again in problem statement it is not mentioned use a velocity factor account for dynamic load. Means we are not in a preliminary stage of gear design. Okay, we are in a final stage of gear design. How to identify we are in a final stages of gear design? All the dimensions are known to you, errors are specified and quality of gear is known to you. Okay, now in problem clearly mention all the dimensions are clearly mentioned, errors are specified and quality of gear is known to you. That's why we are in a final stages of gear design. In final stages the dynamic load is defined by either by spot equation or Buckingham equation. Okay, but in this problem it is not mentioned use spot equation or Buckingham equation. If specially mentioned use spot equation or Buckingham equation, use that particular equation to get the value of dynamic load. Okay, in this problem is not mentioned use spot or Buckingham equation. Here we use a spot equation to get the value of dynamic load. Okay, step number four, dynamic load by spot equation. Everyone knowing the relation of spot equation in case of a bevel gear. Now here we first of all for determining the dynamic load we need an error, total error and the mean radius of pinion and gear. That calculation first of all we do this calculation. Here we know the value of error E is equal to 16 plus 1.25 into inside the bracket modulus plus 0.25 under root 2 R. R is the mean radius, remember that. Okay, for finding the error in pinion, we know the mean radius of pinion. For finding the error in gear, we know the mean radius of gear. Okay, that's why first of all we find out the mean radius of pinion. R1 is the notation for mean radius of pinion. R1 is equal to dp by 2 minus b sine gamma divided by 2. Now substitute the value 80 by 2 minus 20 into sine 33.69 degree divided by 2. Simplify that and we get a mean radius of for pinion. R1 is equal to 34.4530 millimeter. Similarly, mean radius of gear R2 is equal to dg by 2 minus b into cos gamma divided by 2. Now substitute the value 120 by 2 minus 20 into cos 33.69 degree divided by 2. Simplify this and we get a value of a mean radius of a gear 51.6794 millimeter. Now we find out the error in pinion. Error in pinion e sub x p is equal to 16 plus 1.25 into inside the bracket model plus 0.25 under root 2r. Now here we substitute the value of 2r1. Now in this relation just we substitute the value of module and the mean radius of pinion. Okay, 16 plus 1.25 into inside the bracket 4 plus 0.25 under root 2 into mean radius of pinion 34.4530. simplify this and we get the value in microns. 23 point error in pinion e suffix p is equal to 23.5940 microns. Similarly, here we find out the error in gear e suffix g is equal to 16 plus 1.25 into inside the bracket module plus 0.25 under root 2r2. r2 is the mean radius of gear. Now substitute in this relation we substitute the value of module and mean radius of gear. 16 plus 1.25 into inside the bracket 4 plus 0.25 into under root 2 into 51.6794. simplify this and we get an error in pinion e suffix g is equal to 24.1770 microns. Now total error is equal to total error small e is equal to ep plus eg. Now substitute the values, that sum we get a total error e is equal to 47.771 microns, and here it must to convert into millimeter. Okay, remember that it will not put in a micron in the relation of dynamic equation. If you put in a micron, we get a wrong answer. Okay, after getting the error, that error here we get an error in micron and it must to convert into millimeter by multiplying 10 to the power minus 3 or divided by 1000. Okay, now here 47.771 into 10 to the power minus 3 in millimeter. After getting the mean radius of pinion and gear and the total error, now here we use a spot equation to get the value of a dynamic load. Okay, before that here we find out the another one dimension, b dash. B dash is the axial width of a gear blank. B dash, we know the relation for b dash. B dash is equal to b cos gamma. B is 20 cos 33.69 and we get a value of a b dash 16.6410 millimeter. Okay, now here we get a r1 r2 e and b dash. After getting that after getting this value, we use the spot equation to get the value of dynamic load. Okay, now dynamic load p suffix d is equal to, we know the relation for dynamic load according to spot equation, p suffix d is equal to e into speed of pinion into number of teeth on a pinion into b dash into r1 into r2 whole divided by 2530 into under root r1 square plus r2 square. Here we know all the values, substitute these values in this relation and we get a dynamic load. Error 47.771 into 10 to the power minus 3, speed 500 rpm, zp 20, b dash 16.6410, r1 34.4530, r2 51.6794, whole divided by 2530 into under root r1 square 34.4530 square plus r2 square 51.6794 6794 square. Simplify that. And after simplification, we get the value of dynamic load. P suffix D is equal to 90.0740 Newton. Okay. Now the last step, step number 5, rated power. Since the beam strength is lower than the wear strength, beam bending failure is the criteria of design, and therefore SB is equal to, here we know the relation for effective load. Effective load is equal to service factor into tangential force plus dynamic load. Okay, now we know the relation between effective load and beam strength. SB, beam strength, SB is equal to effective load into factor of safety. Okay, here we know the relation between effective beam strength and effective load. Beam strength is equal to effective load into factor of safety. Okay, and therefore we know the relation for effective load. Effective load is service factor into tangential force plus dynamic load. Okay, here substitute there. SB is equal to effective load into factor of safety. Effective load CSPT plus dynamic load into factor of safety. Now here we know all the values, only tangential force is unknown here. Substitute all the values. We know the value of beam strength, 4287.5795 is equal to service factor 1.5 into tangential force PT plus dynamic load 90.0740 into the factor of safety is 2. Now simplify that and we get the value of tangential force PT is equal to 1369.1438 Newton. Now for we know the relation, general relation for power, 2 pi nt divided by 60. Okay, 2 pi nt, here speed is known to you, only torque is unknown. After getting the value of tangential force, here we easily find out the torque. We know the definition of torque. Torque is tangential force into the radius. Okay, now here we find the torque. Torque is equal to m suffix t is equal to tangential force into the radius, pt into dp by 2. Okay, here pinion is weaker, that's why here we use a pinion parameter, and we get a torque 54,765.752 Newton millimeter. After getting the torque, we use the relation of power. Kilowatt is equal to 2 pi n suffix p into m suffix t divided by 60 into 10 to the power 6. Substitute all the values. 2 pi into speed 500 into torque 54,765.752 divided by 60 into 10 to the power 6. Simplify this. And we get a power is in a kilowatt, power 2.8675 kilowatt. This is the answer. This numerical is asked for 7 mark in university examination. If you have any query, please ask. Thank you very much.